In this video, I'll show you how to design an icon in Adobe Illustrator, how to import it into After Effects, and animate it. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. Alright, let's dive right in. We create a new document, 1080 by 1080 pixels, and name it Icon. Then we go into the View menu up here and click Show Grid and Show Rulers. First of all, we create a grid using guides. We place them two big squares in from all sides. An icon almost never comes alone. Icon families keep growing as more and more icons are added later on, so you need to keep that in mind. To ensure some sort of consistency, we need a grid. Let's activate Snap to Grid to make this easier. Then two guides for the center. Awesome. Let's name the layer Guides. Here they are. And we lock it. We add a new layer and name it Icon. Let's create a heart. I'll show you how I do that. We use the ellipse tool to create a round shape, fitting into the left square we created with the guides. Let's add a fill color, red of course. We drag it to the right square while holding Alt or Option to duplicate it at the same time. Then we slightly increase the size, so that they overlap. Then we use the rectangle tool and create a square. The size, roughly one of the shapes. We rotate it 45 degrees and move it up. And complete the heart shape. Hold Shift and Alt or Option while scaling it. And we don't want to snap to the grid anymore. Slightly increase the size until it fits to the two circles and forms one shape. We go into the outline mode, that's easier. We want to be really exact here. We place the two points where the lines touch the circles. And we move the upper point down into the shape. And let's be really exact here. Awesome. We go into Pathfinder and unite the three shapes. And if you've been precise, there are no more than 8 points altogether. Let's create a background shape. We add a new layer called Background. We use the Rectangle tool to add the shape. Size 1080 by 1080 pixels. Let's change the color. And if you pull one of these points towards the center, you add round corners, which we do. Let's move the layer down the stacking order and the heart slightly down in the comp. If you like this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks, guys. I just saved the file, by the way, which you should do as well. All right, there are two ways of importing it to After Effects without using plugins. First one is importing it as a composition, retain layer sizes. Each element you want to be a separate layer needs to be in a separate layer in Illustrator. The other method is to import the Illustrator file as footage, merged layers. Then add it to a comp. Right-click on the layer and create shapes from the vector layer, which will create a shape layer with two shapes. For a simple object like ours, that's the right method. First of all, we duplicate the layer. Name the top one Heart, the bottom one Background. Then we delete the heart shape from the background layer and the background shape from the heart layer. Next, we add a gradient ramp to the background shape. Position the start at the top left corner and of the ramp at the bottom right corner. Colors white and a hint of purple. And we add lots of ramp scatter. Let's actually move the endpoint further away. Next, we add a gradient ramp to the heart. Position the start and end of the ramp again. Colors, this time a nice red and purple towards the lower right edge. And let's add a drop shadow to the heart. Shadow color purple. Distance around 20. Softness 50. Awesome. That's where we want to end up, coming from an empty screen. Let's scale it down though. And let's animate the icon. First of all, we move the start points to 20 frames. Then we duplicate the heart. Move the layer to the beginning, adjust the endpoint. Then we get rid of the fill and set the stroke width to 10 pixels. Or try to. When we open up the group, there is no stroke. So we add a stroke to the group from the add menu. And then we adjust the stroke width, 10 pixels. We delete the gradient ramp and the drop shadow. Next, we add trim paths and set the endpoint to 0 and add a keyframe. At 19 frames, we set it back to 100. We want the animation to start at the bottom corner. So we go back to almost the beginning and set offset to minus 93. We select both keyframes and open the graph editor. Make sure snap is activated and edit speed graph is selected. We slow down the beginning and the end of the animation. Awesome. Next, let's animate a heartbeat. We set a scale keyframe at 20 frames. At 22 frames, we scale it up. At 24 frames, we shrink it. At 28 frames, it's back to the original size. Okay, I think that's too big. And we add Easy Ease In to all keyframes. Awesome. The background. We set scale keyframes at 24 and 35 frames. At 24 frames, we scale it up. And add an opacity keyframe, set the opacity to 0. At 28 frames, we set the opacity to 100%. We select both scale keyframes and slow down the end of the animation in the graph editor. You don't want to animate too much. Most of the times, an icon needs to appear pretty fast, and the animation needs to make sense so a heartbeat works well. That's the basic workflow from designing stuff in Illustrator to then animating it in After Effects. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one. Bye, guys!